For some reason, people think that this cloud coming out of a nuclear power plant is toxic, radioactive, and actually smoke. And this is completely not true. Hello, I'm Elena, your friendly nuclear physicist, and today we're going to debunk a very common myth around the nuclear power plant, and specifically the cooling tower. We're gonna break down this video into three sections, debunking common myths around the cloud that comes out of nuclear power plants, and that is, what is the white cloud we see? Secondly, does it contribute to air pollution and is it toxic? Thirdly, is it radioactive? And if you stay until the end of the video, I'll answer a bonus question, and that is, can it be radioactive? So firstly, the construction out of which the cloud is coming out is called cooling tower, and it literally does what the name suggests. So it takes the warm water out of the nuclear power plant and condenses it, cools it down, and sends it back in. And this is part of the circulation cooling system of a nuclear power plant. Some of the warm water that rises out evaporates, the same way that your water when you're boiling pasta evaporates. And this is actually the cloud we see coming out of the cooling tower. Therefore, the white cloud is steam. It is not smoke. Coming up to the second point, is this cloud toxic or is it bad for air pollution? And debunking that question, the answer is no. The cloud, as we explicitly said in the first question, is just steam. It is basically warm air that is distributed in the environment. So just to answer your question, and so you know for next time, it is not toxic, it does not contribute to air pollution. These kind of towers also exist in power plants that are not nuclear, but for example, in a coal-fired power plant. And in that case, there is filters applied in order to maintain the smoke in a level that is appropriate to be released into the environment. However, in a nuclear power plant, nothing really burns for the energy to be produced, and therefore the steam is pure, clean steam that the water has evaporated from. And coming up to the third and most interesting question, the question that people ask the most, is this cloud radioactive? And I'm gonna leave you guess this answer is no. The cloud that's coming out of a cooling tower is not radioactive. It is actually a separate cooling system that is not in any contact with a nuclear reactor. It circulates around the water just to provide cooling, and therefore it cannot have radioactivity inside it. And now, what you all have been waiting for, bonus question. Can the cloud become radioactive? So that is sort of a tricky question, in a sense that, as I explained in the last section, the cooling system that ends in the cooling tower actually is separated from the reactor. It doesn't go through the reactor. However, there is different kind of constructions in nuclear power plants, and it might be the case that there is only one cooling system passing throughout the reactor and out in the cooling tower. In that case, if there is a rupture in the pipe or if there is a malfunction inside the core of the reactor, the water might get contaminated and radioactive materials might go inside the water circulation system, which can therefore go inside the cooling tower, condense, and some of it will evaporate, as we explained, and then this evaporated steam can actually carry some radioactive material in it. However, this is very unlikely because in most nuclear power plants, there is two circulating systems exactly for this reason, to protect any kind of contamination into the external environment. So now when it comes to environmental pollution and more specifically to marine life, I understand that there might be some arguments regarding the warm water from the cooling tower getting back into the lakes and seas, and because of the difference in temperature, it might affect the aquatic ecosystem and the marine life of the area that the nuclear power plant is located at. Let me know in the comment section below if this is an interesting topic for you to know more about, that I can make a future video about it and discuss it in more detail. Let me also know in the comment section if you would like to know how a nuclear power plant operates in total, and we can also make a video about that in the future. Thanks so much for watching this video. It has been Elena, your friendly nuclear physicist. And until next time, see you soon. It's been Elena. Has been Elena, wow.